I believe that the science of chemistry alone almost proves the existence of an intelligent creator. Good day, students. With this thought, we will begin today's session on the second model of an atom proposed by Hansom Rutherford, and it is popularly known as Rutherford's nuclear atomic model. Here are the few captions given by Ernest Rutherford. I am amazing. I can do anything. Positivity is a choice. I celebrate my individuality. I am prepared to succeed. So with these captions in his mind, he started his experiment known as Rutherford's nuclear model. Rutherford was he was a rich person. Actually, his work was on the radioactivity. While doing work on the radioactivity, he was supplying some radioactive chemicals to the factory. So with his available money, he was doing radioactivity business. But in doing so, he also studied what is there in an atom. So the discovery of nucleus in an atom, the credit goes to Ernest Rutherford. So we'll study how this discovery was made by Rutherford. This is the setup, experimental setup for Rutherford. One point we have to remember here. During Rutherford time, when he was conducting this experiment, the knowledge of radioactivity was known. Radioactivity is the spontaneous emission of certain kinds of radiation. They are classified on the basis of charge: alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays. Three different kinds of rays will come out from a radioactive source. This was known to him, and this is also one of the research topics of Rutherford. Out of the three radiations, he selected alpha particles for his experiment. So this is the source. Whenever you keep any radioactive source such as uranium, polonium, radium, they give out on their own alpha, beta, gamma. So by applying electric field, you can separate alpha rays, and he has selected the alpha rays for his experiment. The reason is alpha rays are speed. Alpha rays are having mass. Alpha rays, I can say, you see, second element on the modern periodic table, it is helium. Its atomic number is 2 and the mass number is 4. That means in the helium, 2 protons, 2 electrons and the 2 neutrons are there. Out of these, if you remove 2 electrons from the helium structure, whatever left is what? It is helium plus 2. Please recall 9th class knowledge. Any element, any atom after losing electron becomes a positive ion, and any atom after gaining electron becomes a negative ion. Here, if you remove 2 electrons from helium, it becomes helium 2 plus. So alpha particles means it is helium 2 plus. This is told by radioactive scientist. When they allowed all the alpha particles to fall in one chamber, then they analyzed the chamber, they came to know that it is a helium nucleus with Hg2+. So alpha particles means it is Hg2+, that you keep in the mind. So he used alpha particles for his experiment and the knowledge of radioactivity. And this one, this is called thin gold sheet. The purpose of using the gold is it is a noble metal. It is highly malleable. So there are some plus points of gold metal. So he has selected the gold metal for his experiment. And this is the screen or detector, or you can say circular cover coated with fluorescent material, right? So that whenever radiation falls, he will come to know because of the spots on the shines on the screen. So this is a screen. You can say it is a screen. This is gold sheet, screen, radioactive source from where alpha particles are made to fall, and slit like a gate entry so that it enters correctly in a disciplined way. So all these are arrangements made by the Rutherford. Yeah. Now, when alpha particle starts hitting the gold foil, gold paper, gold sheet, he saw three observations. This is the observation number one. What? Most of the alpha particles went as it is. They are not showing any deviation or the deflection. Few alpha particles showed deflection of small angles. Whereas third observation was very few alpha particles deflected to a larger angle. Almost they bounced back. So these were the three observations he noticed from his experiment. This side also you can see bouncing back, you can see. So instead of going that side, some very few alpha particles, they were coming back and hitting this side. So he could notice these spots also. But number of these spots are very few. Here, almost 99% spots here only. Few spots were here and very few spots were here. So from these three observations, what was the conclusions? Let us see. This is the first observation. 99.9% of the alpha particles went undeviated, no deflection, straight. Few of them were deflected by small angles. See, they went and showed deflection. They went, showed deflection, small angles. Third observation was very few. He was so clever, he was so accurate. Using the mathematics of chemistry, he calculated, he made a big derivation which is beyond the 11th class textbook. If you are really interested, you can go for the BSc physics. Afterwards, MSc particle physics, you will enjoy this theory. So very few, approximately 1 in 20,000 deflected by large angles. That means this area. This is the observation number one. Observation number two. Observation number three, very few came back or deflected by large angles. Now you will see, after these three observations, what were his conclusions? Conclusions. Very good. Most of the space in an atom is empty. See, if you take Thomson's model as the model for an atom, according to him, it is like a sphere. Entire plus part is over the sphere. If everywhere a positive sphere is there, then alpha particles will go and they will come back. But this not happened in the case of Rutherford. Only few came back, not many. So out of 20,000, it is one is coming back. That means something is there. Therefore, most of the space in an atom is empty. This is the first conclusion. Second conclusion was, positive part resides in a small space at the center. See, why he has concluded this one? Because third observation, very few came back, 1 in 20,000. So that means what? The rays, alpha particles, which were going straight on the axis, on the symmetry of the center of the atom, they were bouncing back. That means at the center of the atom, there is a small region where plus part is residing, and that is known as what? He will name after us now. Okay, please wait for the next conclusion. Positive part is heavy. He has given calculation, as I told in the my previous discussion. 10 to the power minus 10 meter, this is about the atom. 10 to the power minus 15 meters about the nucleus. That means nucleus is very small. How much difference? 10 to the power minus 5, almost 1 lakh difference. Okay. So size of the nucleus is very small compared to the size of the atom. You can compare here. Let us recall once again 9th class knowledge, where we have compared the size of nucleus with the size of the atom. Taking the football to the football ground, keep the football at the center of the ground. So football acts like a nucleus and the ground will act like an atom. So that is the just for comparison to understand what is the model of an atom given by the Rutherford. You see the fourth conclusion, number of positive charges equal to number of negative charges, that means electrical neutrality is maintained. Thomas told the same thing. So some points of Thomas are carried here. Atom is electrically neutral. Number of protons are equal to number of electrons. Number of negative charge equal to number of positive charge. All these are maintained here. Neutron hint was there during that time. But hint, it is a hint. But it was not discovered. It was discovered later. So idea was there, but it was not discovered. Size of the atom is 1 lakh times more than the size of its nucleus. Same football and the stadium comparison. So this is a very important point given by the Rutherford. The electron revolves around the nucleus in closed circular orbits. First time in the history of chemistry, he concluded about the motion of electrons. Earlier, we thought electrons were static. Here and there use some reactions, but here now electrons are moving, they are mobile. So this point is told by the Rutherford. He has compared his model with the existing solar model. Sun at the center and planets taking round like that. Nucleus at the center, electrons taking the round. But who is controlling them? Who is controlling them? Here is the point. Electron is negative, nucleus is positive. So there is the electrostatic force of attraction. Then whenever any particle, or for example, when you tie a stone to a thread and rotate, so it wants to go out, but you are holding. That is called circular motion. So because of the circular motion, an electron around nucleus, electron develops a force known as the centripetal force. One force acting outward and one force acting inward, and both these are balanced, he told. So force because of electrostatic, force because centripetal, both are equal, balanced. Therefore, electron revolve around the nucleus intact. No doubt he has given wonderful, but still it suffers from some failure or some drawbacks. This is according to the electromagnetic theory given by James Maxwell, the great scientist of the modern chemistry. Any accelerated charged particle emits radiation and loses energy. If this happens, then this electron will radiate energy and lose energy, and slowly it will go, it go and collapse into the nucleus, which is what? Unstable atom. But atom is stable. Let us see what happens. Now, line spectrum not explained by Rutherford. When you pass a light into the sample, this type of spectrum is formed. We will learn this one afterwards. But this is not explained by the Rutherford. So because of these two failures, no doubt, wonderful model. The credit of discovery of nucleus goes to the Rutherford, but still it suffers some limitations. So if anyone is there to rectify the limitations, I think we will go for the next model. So in our next model, we will discuss still better, where he explains how electron-nucleus relations are there. So in our next session, we will discuss the third model. Thank you.